And as we walked, I heard the laughter in the leaves. See the shadows lying now where once we stood.
I guess I heard about it from friends or something, and then I thought it sounded cool and something I wanted to get into.
The first time you get drugged and you realize the power the kite has, there's no way to explain it.
The speed, of course, and I go up there on vacation with the girls every year, and I saw kiteboarders down on top of the beach, and I ran down one time and talked to the guy. I said, "It's so easy, it's not hard on your back," and he was going to do some competition, and it just looked so smooth coming out of the air and just ran onto the beach. It just looks like
fun. A buddy of mine was doing it, and he said it was really cool, and I went out and watched him and a couple other guys, and it looked pretty fun, so I windsurf and snowboard and stuff, so I thought this would be a good summertime activity.
Miatonna Point, place on Old Mission Peninsula where we grew up. Everybody back in the day would call it Nia, just chilling at Nia. And then when we started the business, you know, we were brothers, so we had the bro, the Nia. Put it all together, we had the Bronia combination.
M22 is such a tight area because everything around it is surrounded by water. There's a coastline on three sides. It's just a big massive peninsula, and the road runs right along the entire coast through beautiful forests, mellow little towns, just incredible views, and it's just one of those places that's a little secret that no one else in the world knows about.
All in the garden thread lies broken on the loom. I see a face, it's smiling, flicker on the wall. And in the distance, mountain.
All right, here's day one. In the Michigan house, I'm about to start the internship. It's gonna rack, give you a quick tour. Here's the Saw room. It was the costumes used from the movie Saw to create the look. We have what's gonna be the showroom. The main floor for retail. A little kitchen. A little bathroom. And we'll do more later.
Part of the deal for staying at the house was agreeing to work on the house. And although it was hard work, it was awesome seeing it all pay off in the end. Camps, we start in the classroom first. This is so we get a good foundation of the principles of kiteboarding. With the wind, the weather, the board, we go over all the basics so when the students get to the beach, they know exactly what to expect. After a quick stop at Subway, we cruise down to our private access and start the lesson.
Empire, I'm here to the
that makes me more excited than seeing my students get up and ride, especially on the first day. However, we also go over all of the safety stuff in real good detail so that our students feel incredibly safe when they get out and go on their own. In some of the light wind days, we'll even go out behind the jet ski and work on board skills. Every Monday morning, we'd have a meeting to go over the past weekend's camp and see how it went. If there was anything to improve, we'd take notes and try to make it better for the next week. We'd also set up the game plan for the following week to come and see what needed to be done for that as well. When I first arrived, things were in full swing in preparation for the M22 Challenge, which was held on June 20th. I was able to take part in the planning and ultimately the timing of the event, and it was a great experience. And I got super good at folding clothes.
Just give me a synopsis of what the challenge is all about.
Challenge? It's all about the beauty of this area. Out in Glen Arbor, it's absolutely gorgeous, and the boys started kiteboarding there years ago, and they just fell in love with that area and M22 and everything along it. And Glen Arbor happens to be one of those spots. So Glen Arbor has a combination of dunes, beautiful lakes, and beautiful roads with winding hills and forests. And so it seemed to be the perfect spot to do a triathlon that includes biking and running and a dune climb and kayaking or paddleboarding.
So what was the inspiration for the M22 challenge?
Find something that pulls the local community together, something fun, healthy, outdoors, something that a variety of people could be involved in.
This is Kagan Gill, future winner of the M22 challenge. Kagan, tell me a little bit about your race strategy.
Well, basically I'm going to go as hard as I can the whole time. That's my strategy. Pretty complicated to follow, I know. But
I'm excited about doing the 22 challenge. Hopefully I will not finish last, or at least we'll still have the clock on when I'm done.
I'll be timing it. I'll wait for you.
I will be successful if the clock is still on and there's somebody there.
All right. Some thoughts on the boat, the challenge?
My thoughts on the challenge is I really didn't know what was going on today. I thought people were going to be kiteboarding and swimming and like dancing into the finish line. I didn't know it was a legitimate triathlon, but
it's the real deal.
Pretty stoked to be at the final buoy. Bring everyone in the home stretch.
Give me something.
Hey, I'm 22.
Tell me your thoughts.
No.
Challenge.
I think it's badass.
It's badass?
Yeah.
In only its first year, the M22 Challenge was a huge success, with over 140 people entering the race. The weather turned out just perfect, and everyone seemed super stoked about the whole event. Bronia's very own Kagan Gill took sixth place overall and first in his own age class. The next big thing of the summer was Cherry Fest. Every summer, Traverse City hosts Cherry Festival, which is a national thing that thousands of people come to from all across the country. I was able to capture some of the locals' perspectives on the event.
I like Cherry Festival because it's good for the businesses around town. It brings in a lot of new people. I just really hate the traffic.
Wonderful atmosphere.
It's a fair. It's fun. I don't know.
Cherries, like cherries, good fruit. I think in general, Cherry Festival is a good thing, but I will say that if you live downtown and you want to go for a run, like I just tried to do, it's not going to happen on the sidewalk, and it probably won't happen in the street either.
Cherry Fest this year. Well, I think we've had great weather for it, number one. Started out a little bit cooler, but I think that brought a lot of traffic downtown. Definitely a lot of traffic in the store, and I think it's surprising that there's a recession right now, so I think Cherry Fest is good for Northern Michigan.
It doesn't suck because it's very good for the struggling Michigan economy.
Okay.
After all the madness of Cherry Fest, I was able to finally catch my breath and do a little resting. was able to finally do some of the fun stuff I'd wanted to do all summer, like jump off the dunes, and I even got to go home on a road trip and show Steve where I came from and go to my buddy Paul's wedding. After a few days of trying to convince Steve why my hometown and home area was so cool, it really got me excited to get back to Glen Arbor and start interviewing people about why they thought M22 was so cool.
Sutherland, and I'm a long-time Glen Arbor resident. My family started coming up here in 1955 when I was a year and a half old. I walked over the sand dunes at a year and a half, 7 miles from the dune climb all the way to Lake Michigan. And our family has been in love with this area ever since. I'm living in paradise. It's the fountain of youth. I love it here. I've been to places all over the world, and there's nothing better than Glen Lake, Glen Arbor, and Leelanau County, our land of delight. Thank you.
I'm Elise, and I live in Maple City, and I guess I like M22 because it goes everywhere. I think that's pretty cool.
What's your favorite spot in this area?
I like Empire.
A number of reasons why I like being here is that it is a much slower pace after the summer, although there are people visiting all year round now, but Glen Arbor just empties out, and it becomes a much quieter place.
Well, my name is Mike, and I live around the corner here, and part of working in Glen Arbor is it's a laid-back destination place. So it's hanging out in the winery, serving up some wines.
My name is Dr. Jessica Carden. I'm from Revive Chiropractic in Glen Arbor, in Lake Leelanau, and on Beaver Island. To me, lately, it's my commute to work. I live in the middle, so I go on 22 South to get here, and I go on 22 North to get to my other location. And when someone's going slow in front of me, I actually really enjoy that, because I can enjoy the scenery for a little bit, and just kind of remember the pace is why I'm here. 22 gets you anywhere you actually want to go and nowhere that you don't want to go.
I just love the area because it's beautiful and I grew up here. My family actually started Lake Leelanau, so.
Wow.
Yep.
It's pretty sweet.
I love being able to come back here during the summer after school.
I think it's like a cool
like
thing
road,
because
like road out here, the main
it connects like all the counties, Suttons Bay, Leland, Northport, and even people from like not around here connect to it. So I think it's kind of a cool inside joke that everybody has. I see like the bumper stickers and stuff on people's cars from downstate, and it's just cool, and it kind of, since we're all such small communities, it kind of brings us all together in a way. So I don't know.
What's your favorite place here?
Probably Leland, because you can see like the old fish town and the new, and you can see the beautiful sunset and the mansion, and it's a really cool place to be.
What do you think about the M22 brand?
I think that it is cool, but I think it wouldn't work out very well if every state tried to do that, or every highway. I don't think it would work.
I'm Ashley, and I am from Lake Leelanau, Michigan, but I work in Leland here at Tug Stuff, and I really like just like the small town, because you know, you have your tourists, but then it's really quiet in the winter, and you know, it's a quiet little area where you know everybody, which is pretty cool, I think.
Nice.
Small school, and you get to interact really closely with all your friends.
What do you like about this area?
Well,
don't make it some cheese.
I like how nice the people are. Like the Sutherlands, been very nice to me. I like the water. I like that you can kite anywhere. I like the sand. There's beaches everywhere.
My name is Lisa, and I work at the Leland Beach Company in Fishtown. As I was saying, it's not the road itself, it's where the road takes you. The thing about what people like about this neck of the woods is, I think for me, it's the history. It's knowing about all the people that have lived in this area, and the history and the lumbering business, and the topography, as beautiful as it is just one facet of it. And I think it's just it hasn't been corrupted. You know, it's low key. The people are real, and I don't know, just a great place to be. From Sipping Bear Dunes National Lakeshore, it's just nice. It's like the whole Sipping Bear Dunes National Lakeshore is all part of your own backyard. You can go walking on there and explore it, and just beautiful.
Hello, my name is Mike Sutherland. I was born and raised here in Glen Arbor, and I like it here a lot. I'm the owner of the Crystal River Canoe and Kayak Rental and a miniature golf course here in town, and we had Jasper here do some work for us with some longboarding and paddle boarding. It's great having him around. But we have 55 boats and we do eco tours, but most of our business is taking folks down the Crystal River. The river runs 11 miles from Little Fisher Lake, which is connected to Big Fisher, Big Glen, and Little Glen, just east of the sand dunes. And ends up, the mouth is in Lake Michigan. Glen Arbor is 36 square miles of land, and in 1970 the National Park came and took 30 out of the 36, turning this into one of the most unique spots in the whole country, in the world, really. There was talk of making the sand dunes the eighth wonder of the world, and there's still talk about that. It's an amazing resource for us up here in northern Michigan. So if you get the chance to get out here, stop in at the river and grab a paddle and get out on the river, or grab a putter and get out on our putting course.
Everything here is pretty sweet. I can't think of a better place to kite. When the wind is on here, it's the best place to be in the world.
So what do you think about M22 and the road and the company and all that?
I mean, M22 kind of is the gateway to all the sick spot, like the sickest kiting spots here. Frankfort area and Point Betsy area. When the waves build there, I mean, it's just like being in California, Hawaii somewhere with the waves. And the water's fresh, warm, no sharks. So it's cool.
This area, because you can do pretty much anything. You can like go surfing, kiting now. It's awesome. It's like, I don't know. And then you still get the winter, but you got summers, just like it's tropical paradise or something, and the water's sweet.
For me, it represents, you know, some of the best places to go out and kiteboard and some of the best scenery and beaches to be on in the entire United States. So to me, it's life for sure.
Perfect.
Northern Michigan is, the best way to describe it is fresh. It's just fresh water, fresh air, clean air, big trees, great people, just everything you would ever really want in life we can find right here for a good solid 6 months. And yeah, that's what's so great about the area. It's everybody, the environment, and the people.
This summer's internship has been absolutely amazing. Not only have I enjoyed myself and had a great time teaching kiteboarding, I've made a ton of lifelong friends and really figured out a lot about my own life. At the beginning of the summer, I promised someone that I would check back into life, because at times I feel like I almost check out.
Searching all of my days, all of my days. Many a road, you know, I've been walking on all of my days.
Now that this summer's coming to a close, I can say with certainty that I've kept my promise. Being in this area and seeing all of the wonderful landscape and people and everything that it has to offer has truly changed my life.
I have been quietly standing in the shade all of my days. Watch the sky breaking on the promise that we made all of this rain. And I've been trying to find what's been in my mind as the days keep turning into night.
After only 3 months of living here, I'm almost starting to feel like I'm at home. It makes it easy to see why the people that live here are so proud of their own area.
Well, many a night I found myself with no friends standing near. All of my days.
If you ever get a chance, visit Northern Michigan. Anywhere from Traverse City to Glen Arbor to Empire to anywhere on M22, it's all amazing.
For I look around me and my eyes confound me.
One, two, three.
On the way home, I drove through Chicago, and that was a great reminder of how special the area I just left truly is.
Every scream went.
Not only did I get to explore a lot, I also made some of the greatest friends of my entire life.
All the makeup in.
I feel like Michigan is now my second home.
Scars.
If I ever need a place to go, there's so many supportive people there.
I'll
always be there for me.
Some toiletries, the rolling hills, and
outdoor recreation was the basis for me going there. But I realized that it has so much more to offer than that. If you ever get the chance, go to Northern Michigan. I promise you won't regret it.
You never learn, the rules have changed.